This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The race to the sea took place from about the 17th of September to the 19th of October 1914, after the Battle of the Frontiers the 7th of August to the 13th of September and the German advance into France, which had been stopped at the First Battle of the Marne 5-12 September and was followed by the First Battle of the Aisne the 13th of September to the 28th of September, a Franco-British counter-offensive. The term described reciprocal attempts by the Franco-British and German armies to envelop the northern flank of the opposing army through Picardy, Artois and Flanders, rather than an attempt to advance northwards to the sea. The race ended on the North Sea coast of Belgium around the 19th of October, when the last open area from Dixmude to the North Sea was occupied by Belgian troops, who had been withdrawn from the Siege of Antwerp the 28th of September to the 10th of October. The outflanking attempts had resulted in a number of encounter battles, but neither side was able to gain a decisive victory after the opposing forces had reached the North Sea. Both tried to conduct offensives, that led to the mutually costly and indecisive Battle of the Yser the 16th of October to the 2nd of November and the First Battle of Ypres the 19th of October to the 22nd of November. After mid-November, local operations were carried out by both sides and preparations were made to take the offensive in the spring of 1915. Erich von Falkenhayn, chief of the German General Staff Oberst Heeresleitung since the 14th of September, concluded that a decisive victory could not be achieved on the Western Front and that it was equally unlikely in the East. Falkenhayn abandoned Wernicke's strategy of annihilation and attempted to create the conditions for peace with one of Germany's enemies, by Ermating's strategy of exhaustion, to enable Germany to concentrate its resources decisively to defeat the remaining opponents over the winter lull. The French army established the theoretical basis of offensive trench warfare and originated many of the methods which became standard for the rest of the war. Infiltration tactics were developed in which dispersed formations of infantry were followed by nettoyeurs de tranchée, trench cleaners, to capture strong points that had been bypassed. Artillery observation from aircraft and creeping barrages were first used systematically in the Second Battle of Artois the 9th of May to the 18th of June 1915. Falkenhayn issued memoranda on 7 and the 25th of January 1915 to govern defensive battle on the Western Front, in which the existing front line was to be fortified so that it could be held indefinitely with small numbers of troops to enable more divisions to be sent to the Eastern Front. New defenses were to be built behind the front line to contain a breakthrough, until the position was restored by counter-attacks. The West here began the huge task of building fortifications, which were not complete until the autumn of 1915. Contents 1. Background 11. Strategic developments 111. Plan 17. 112. Schlieffen-Moltke Plan 113. Battle of the Frontiers, the 7th of August to the 13th of September 114. The Great Retreat, the 24th of August to the 5th of September 115. Eastern Front 12. Tactical developments 121. Operations in Belgium, August-October 1914 122. First Battle of the Marne, 5-12 September 123. First Battle of the Aisne, 13-28 September 2nd Prelude 21. German Plan of Attack 22. French Plan of Attack 3. Battle 31. First Phase, the 25th of September to the 4th of October 311. Battle of Picardy, 22-26 September 312. Battle of Albert, 25-29 September 32. Second Phase, 4-15 October 321. First Battle of Arras, 1-4 October 33. Third Phase, 15 October to November 331. Battle of La Bassée, the 10th of October to the 2nd of November 332. Battle of Messines, the 12th of October to the 2nd of November 333. Battle of Armentières, the 13th of October to the 2nd of November 4. Aftermath 41. Analysis 42. Casualties 5. Subsequent operations 51. First Battle of Flanders 511. Battle of the Yser, the 18th of October to the 30th of November 512. First Battle of Ypres, the 19th of October to the 22nd of November 6. Notes 7. Footnotes 8. References 9. Further reading 10. External links. Background. Strategic developments. Main Articles, Plan 17 in Schlieffen Plan. Plan 17 Main Article, Plan 17 Under Plan 17 the French peacetime army was to form five field armies, with groups of reserve divisions attached, and a group of reserve divisions was to assemble on each flank, see 2 million men. The armies were to concentrate opposite the German frontier around Epinal, Nancy and Verdun Charleville-Mézières, with an army in reserve around Saint-Menehould and Commercy. Since 1871 railway building had given the French general staff 16 lines to the German frontier against 13 available to the German army, and the French could wait until German intentions were clear. The French deployment was intended to be ready for a German offensive in Lorraine or through Belgium. It was anticipated that the Germans would use reserve troops, but also expected that a large German army would be mobilized on the border with Russia, leaving the Western Army with sufficient troops only to advance through Belgium south of the Meuse and the Sambre rivers. French intelligence had obtained a map exercise of the German general staff of 1905, in which German troops had gone no further north than Namur, and assumed that plans to besiege Belgian forts were a defensive measure against the Belgian army. A German attack from southeastern Belgium towards Mézières and a possible offensive from Lorraine towards Verdun, Nancy and Saint-Dié was anticipated. The plan was an evolution from Plan 16 and made more provision for the possibility of a German offensive through Belgium. The 1st, 2nd and 3rd armies were to concentrate between Epinal and Verdun opposite Alsace and Lorraine, the 5th army was to assemble from Montmédy to Sedan and Mézières, and the 4th army was to be held back west of Verdun, ready to move east to attack the southern flank of a German invasion through Belgium or southwards against the northern flank of an attack through Lorraine. No formal provision was made for combined operations with the British Expeditionary Force BEF, but joint arrangements had been made, and in 1911 during the Second Moroccan Crisis the French had been told that 6 divisions could be expected to operate around Maubeuge. Schlieffen Moltke Plan. Main Article, Schlieffen Plan. German strategy had given priority to offensive operations against France and a defensive posture against Russia. Since 1891 German planning was determined by numerical inferiority, the speed of mobilization and concentration, and the effect of the vast increase of the power of modern weapons. Frontal attacks were expected to be costly and protracted, leading to limited success, particularly after the French and Russians modernized their fortifications on the frontiers with Germany. Alfred von Schlieffen, chief of the Imperial German General Staff, Oberst Heeresleitung Ulm from 1891 to 1906, devised plans to evade the French frontier fortifications with an offensive on the flank, which would have a local numerical superiority and obtain rapidly a decisive victory by 1906. Such a maneuver was intended to pass through neutral Belgium and threaten Paris from the north. Helmut von Moltke the Younger succeeded Schlieffen in 1906 and was less certain that the French would conform to German assumptions. Moltke adapted the deployment and concentration plan to accommodate an attack in the center or an enveloping attack from both flanks as variants to the plan, by adding divisions to the left flank opposite the French frontier. From the sea, 1,700,000 men expected to be mobilized in the west. Here Western Army, the main German force, would still advance through Belgium and attack southwards into France. The French armies would be enveloped on the left and pressed back over the Meuse, Aisne, Somme, Oise, Marne and Seine. Unable to withdraw into central France, the French would either be annihilated or the maneuver from the north would create conditions for victory in the centre or in Lorraine on the common border. Battle of the Frontiers, 7 August to 13 September. Main Article, Battle of the Frontiers. France, Germany, Luxembourg and Belgium, 1914. The Battle of the Frontiers is a general name for all of the operations of the French armies until the Battle of the Marne. A series of encounter battles began between the German, French and Belgian armies, on the German-French frontier and in southern Belgium on 4 August. 1914 – The Battle of Mulhouse. Battle of Alsace. 7-10 August was the first French offensive against Germany. The French captured Mulhouse until forced out by a German counterattack on 11 August and fell back toward Belfort. The main French offensive, the Battle of Lorraine. 14-25 August, began with the battles of Morhange and Sarrebourg. 14-20 August, advances by the 1st Army on Sarrebourg and the 2nd Army towards Morhange. Chateau Salins near Morhange was captured on 17 August and Sarreborg the next day. The German 6th Army and 7th Army counter-attacked on 20 August and the 2nd Army was forced back from Morhange and the 1st Army was repulsed at Sarreborg. The German armies crossed the border and advanced on Nancy but were stopped to the east of the city. To the south, the French retook Mulhouse on 19 August and then withdrew on 24 August at the Battle of the Mortain. 14-25 August, a limited German offensive in the Vosges. The Germans managed a small advance, before a French counterattack retook the ground. By 20 August, a German counter-offensive in Lorraine had begun and the German 4th Army and 5th Army advanced through the Ardennes on 19 August towards Neufchâteau. An offensive by French 3rd and 4th Armies through the Ardennes began on 20 August. In support of the French invasion of Lorraine, the opposing armies met in thick fog and the French mistook the German troops for screening forces. On 22 August, the Battle of the Ardennes. 21-28 August began with French attacks, which were costly to both sides and forced the French into a disorderly retreat. Late on 23 August, the 3rd Army recoiled towards Verdun, pursued by the 5th Army, and the 4th Army retreated to Sedan, and Stenay-Mulhouse was recaptured again by German forces. And the Battle of the Meuse, 26-28 August, caused a temporary halt of the German advance. Battle of the Frontiers, 1914. Liège was occupied by the Germans on 7 August. The first units of the BEF landed in France and French troops crossed the German frontier on 12 August. The Battle of Halen was fought by German and Belgian cavalry and infantry and was a Belgian defensive success. The BEF completed its move of 4 divisions and a cavalry division to France on 16 August, as the last Belgian fort of the fortified position of Liège surrendered. The Belgian government withdrew from Brussels on 18 August and the German army attacked the Belgian Field Army at the Battle of the Gette. Next day the Belgian army began to retire towards Antwerp, which left the route to Namur open. Longwy and Namur were besieged on 20 August. Further west, the 5th Army had concentrated on the Sambre by 20 August, facing north either side of Charleroi and east towards the Belgian fortified position of Namur on the left. The Cavalry Corps General André Sordet linked with the BEF at Mons. The 5th Army was confronted by the German 3rd Army and 2nd Army from the east and the north before the 5th Army could attack over the Sambre. The 2nd Army attacked at the Battle of Charleroi and at Namur on 21 August. The 3rd Army crossed the Meuse and attacked the French right flank, and on 23 August, the 5th Army began a retirement southwards to avoid encirclement after the Battle of Saint-Quentin. The French withdrawal continued on 22 August. The BEF had advanced and on 23 August fought the Battle of Mons, a delaying action against the German 1st Army. To protect the left flank of the French 5th Army, the BEF was forced to retreat. When the 1st Army began to overrun the British defences on the right flank and the 5th Army retired from the area south of the Sambre and exposed the British right flank to envelopment, Namur capitulated on 25 August and a Belgian sortie from Antwerp led to the Battle of Malines. 25-27 August, after the French defeat during the Battle of Lorraine, the French 2nd Army retreated to the Grand Couronne Heights near Nancy and dug in, on an arc from Pont-à-Mousson to Champenoux, Luneville and Dombasle-sur-Meurthe. By 3 September, the Battle of Grand Couronne. 4-13 September began next day, when the German 7th and 6th Armies attacked simultaneously at Saint-Dié and Nancy, as the 2nd Army sent reinforcements to the 3rd Army. Costly fighting continued until 12 September, but the French were able to withdraw more than 4 corps to reinforce the armies on the left flank on 13 September. Pont-à-Mousson and Luneville were recaptured by the French and the advance continued close to the Say River, where the front stabilized. The battles kept a large number of German troops in Lorraine, as the Great Retreat further west culminated on the Marne. The Great Retreat, 24 August to 5 September. Main article, Great Retreat. German and Allied positions, 23 August to 5 September 1914. The French 5th Army fell back about 10 miles. 16 day British Marines and a party of the Royal Naval Air Service RNAS landed at Ostend. Lille and Mezières were occupied by German troops. Arras was occupied on 27 August and a French counter-offensive began at the Battle of Saint-Quentin, also known as the Battle of Guise. 29-30 August, on 29 August the 5th Army counter-attacked the 2nd Army south of the Oise, from Vervins to Mont d'Origny and west of the river from Mont d'Origny to Moy towards Saint-Quentin on the Somme, while the British held the line of the Oise west of La Fire-Lon. La Fire, and Roy were captured by German troops on 30 August and Amiens the next day. On 1 September Crayon and Soissons were captured, and on 5 September the BEF ended its retreat from Mons. German troops reached Clay, 10 miles. 16 Sampans, against the 4th Army, which had advanced from Rethel, to Suippes and the west of Chalons. The new 9th Army held a line from Mailly against the 3rd Army, which had advanced from Mézières, over the Vesle and the Marne west of Chalons. The 2nd Army had advanced from Marle on the Serre, across the Aisne and the Vesle, between Reims and Fismes to Montmort, north of the junction of the 9th and 5th Armies at Sézanne. The 5th Army and the BEF had withdrawn south of the Oise, Serre, Aisne and Auercue, pursued by the 2nd Army on a line from Guise to Laon, Vailly and Dormans, and by the 1st Army from Montdidier, towards Compiègne and then southeast towards Montmirail. The new French 6th Army, linked with the left of the BEF, west of the Marne at Meaux, to Pontoise north of Paris. French garrisons were besieged at Strasbourg, Metz, Thionville, Longwy, Montmedy and Maubeuge. The Belgian army was invested at Antwerp in the National Redoubt and at Liège. Fortress troops continued the defence of the fort's Eastern Front. Eastern Front, 1914. Austria-Hungary had declared war on Serbia on the 28th of July, and on 1 August, military operations began on the Polish border. Libo was bombarded by a German cruiser on 2 August, and on 5 August, Montenegro declared war on Austria-Hungary on 6 August, Austria-Hungary declared war on Russia and Serbia declared war on Germany. War began between Montenegro and Germany on 8 August. The Battle of Stolypon, the 17th of August, caused a minor check to the Russian invasion of East Prussia, and on the 12th of August, Britain and France declared war on Austria-Hungary. As Austrian forces crossed the Save and seized Shabitz next day, Austrian forces crossed the Dina and began the first invasion of Serbia. The Battle of Cer, Battle of the Jadar, 17 to 21 August began, and the Battle of Gumbinnen in East Prussia took place from 19 to 20 August. On the 21st of August, Austro-Hungarian forces withdrew from Serbia. The Battle of Tannenberg, 26-30 August began in East Prussia, and in the Battle of Galicia, the 23rd of August to the 11th of September, the First Battle of Krasnik was fought in Poland from 23-25 August. Shabitz was retaken by Serbian forces and the last Austrian troops retired across the Dina, ending the first Austrian invasion of Serbia. The First Battle of Lemberg, 26-30 August began in Galicia, and the Battle of Komaro, the 26th of August to the 2nd of September, and the Battle of Gnila Lipa, 26-30 August began in Poland. A naval action took place off the Åland Islands, and a German cruiser SMS Magdeburg ran aground and was intercepted by a Russian squadron Silesia, 1914. On 3 September, Lemberg was captured by the Russian army, and the Battle of Rawa, Battle of Tarnavka, 7-9 September began in Galicia. The First Battle of the Masurian Lake, 7-14 September began, and on 8 September, the Austro-Hungarian army commenced the second invasion of Serbia, leading to the Battle of Dina, the 6th of September to the 4th of October. The Second Battle of Lemberg, 8-11 September began, and on the 11th of September, Austrian forces in Galicia retreated. The Battle of the Masurian Lakes ended on the 15th of September, and Chernowitz in Bukovina was taken by the Russian army on the 17th of September. Serbian forces in Sirmia were withdrawn and Semlin evacuated. As the Battle of the Dina ended next day, General Paul von Hindenburg was appointed Oberbefehlshaber der Gesamten Deutschen Streitkraft im Osten, Ober-Ost, Commander-in-Chief of German armies in the Eastern Theater. On 21 September, Jaroslaw in Galicia was taken by the Russian army on 24 September, Pshemyshl was isolated by Russian forces, beginning the first siege as Russian forces conducted the first invasion of North Hungary. The 24 September to 8 October military operations began on the Niemen, 25-29 September, but German attacks were suspended on 29 September. The retreat of Austro-Hungarian forces in Galicia ended, and Maramaro Sziget was captured by the Russian army. An Austro-Hungarian counter-offensive began on 4 October, and Maramaro Sziget was retaken on 9 October. The first German offensive against Warsaw began with the battles of Warsaw, 9-19 October, and Ivangorod, 9-20 October. As the situation on the Eastern Front deteriorated in September, the new German High Command under General Falkenhayn attempted to retrieve the situation in France and inflict a decisive defeat. Tactical developments. Operations in Belgium, August-October 1914. Main articles: German invasion of Belgium and Siege of Antwerp, 1914. German invasion of Belgium, August 1914. On 2 August 1914, the Belgian government refused the passage of German troops through Belgium to France, and on the night of 3/4 August, the Belgian General Staff ordered the 3rd Division to Liege to obstruct a German advance covered by the 3rd Division, the Liege Fortress Garrison, a screen of the Cavalry Division and detachments from Liege and Namur. The rest of the Belgian Field Army closed up to the River Gette by 4 August, covering central and western Belgium and the communications towards Antwerp. The German invasion began on 4 August, when an advanced force of 6 German brigades from the 1st, 2nd and 3rd Armies, crossed the German-Belgian border. Belgian resistance and German fear of Frank's tirers led the Germans to implement a policy of Schrecklichkeit, frightfulness, against Belgian civilians soon after the invasion, in which massacres, executions, hostage-taking and the burning of towns and villages took place and became known as the Rape of Belgium. On 5 August, the advanced German forces tried to capture Liege and the forts of the fortified position of Liege by coup de main. The city fell on 6 August, but the forts were not captured, and on 12 August, 5 German super-heavy 420mm 17. Its positions along the Gette, to the National Redoubt at Antwerp. On 20 August, the German First Army took Brussels unopposed and the Belgian Field Army reached Antwerp, with little interference from German advanced parties, except for an engagement between the 1st Division and the German 9th Corps near Tienen, in which the Belgians had 1,630 casualties, while the BEF and the French armies conducted the Great Retreat into France. 24 August to 28 September, small detachments of the Belgian, French and British armies conducted operations in Belgium against German cavalry and Jaeger. On 27 August, a squadron of the RNAS had flown to Ostend, for air reconnaissance sorties between Bruges, Ghent and Ypres. British Marines landed at Dunkirk on the night of 19-20 September, and on 28 September occupied Lille. The rest of the brigade occupied Kassel on 30 September and scouted the country in motor cars. An RNAS armoured car section was created, by fitting vehicles with bullet-proof steel. On 2 October, the Marine Brigade was moved to Antwerp, followed by the rest of the Naval Division on 6 October. Having landed at Dunkirk on the night of 4-5 October from 6-7 October, the 7th Division and the 3rd Cavalry Division landed at Zeebrugge. Naval forces collected at Dover were formed into a separate unit, which became the Dover Patrol, to operate in the Channel and off the French-Belgian coast fortified region of Antwerp. Antwerp was invested to the south and east by German forces after 20 August, while the main German armies chased the French and British over the border and pursued them southwards to the Marne. Belgian forces in Antwerp tried to assist the French and British with sorties on 24-26 August, 9-13 September and 26-27 September. On 28 September, German heavy and super-heavy artillery began to bombard Belgian fortifications around Antwerp. On 1 October, the Germans attacked forts Sint-Kateligne-Waver and Willem and the Bosbeek and Dorpvelde redoubts, held by the 5th Reserve and Marine Divisions. By 11 a.m., Fort Willem was severely damaged and Fort Lear was hit by 16 inches 410. Main article, First Battle of the Marne. Battle of the Marne, 1914. Joffre used the railways which had transported French troops to the German frontier to move troops back from Lorraine and Alsace to form a new 6th Army under General Michel-Joseph Monory, with 9 divisions and 2 cavalry divisions. By 10 September, 20 divisions and 3 cavalry divisions had been moved west from the German border to the French centre and left, and the balance of force between the German 1st, 2nd and 3rd Armies and the 3rd, 4th, 9th, 5th Armies, the BEF and 6th Army had changed to 44 to 56 divisions. Late on 4 September, Joffre ordered the 6th Army to attack eastwards over the Ourcq towards Chateau Thierry as the BEF advanced towards Montmirail, and the 5th Army attacked northwards, with its right flank protected by the 9th Army along the Saint-Gond marshes. The French 1st, 2nd, 3rd and 4th Armies to the east were to resist the attacks of the German 5th, 6th and 7th Armies between Verdun and Toul and repulse an enveloping attack on the defences south of Nancy from the north. The 6th and 7th Armies were reinforced by heavy artillery from Metz and attacked again on 4 September along the Moselle. On 5 September, the 6th Army advanced eastwards from Paris and met the German 4th Reserve Corps, which had moved into the area that morning and stopped the French advance short of high ground north of Meaux overnight. The 4th Reserve Corps withdrew to a better position 10 kilometers 62. The German retreat the pursuit was too slow and by 14 September, the German armies had dug in north of the Aisne and the Allies met trench lines, rather than rearguards frontal attacks by the 9th, 5th and 6th armies were repulsed from 15-16 September, which led Joffre to begin the transfer of the 2nd Army west to the left flank of the 6th Army, the first phase of the operations to outflank the German armies, which from 17 September to 17-19 October, moved the opposing armies through Picardy and Flanders, to the North Sea Coast. First Battle of the Aisne, 13-28 September. Main article, First Battle of the Aisne. Opposing positions, the 5th of September dashed line, the 13th of September black line. On the 10th of September, the French armies and the BEF advanced to exploit the victory of the Marne, and the armies on the left flank advanced, opposed only by rearguards on 11 and the 12th of September. Joffre ordered outflanking maneuvers, but the advance was too slow to catch the Germans, who on the 14th of September, began to dig in on high ground on the north bank of the Aisne, which reduced the French advance from 15-16 September to a few local gains. French troops had begun to move westwards on 2 September, over undamaged railways which could move a corps to the left flank in from 5-6 days. On 17 September, the French 6th Army attacked from Soissons to Noyon, with the 13th and 4th Corps, supported by the 61st and 62nd Divisions of the 6th Group of Reserve Divisions, after which the fighting moved north to Lassigny and the French dug in around Nampcel. The French 2nd Army arrived from the eastern flank and took over command of the left-hand corps of the 6th Army, as indications appeared that German troops were also being moved from the eastern flank. The German 9th Reserve Corps arrived from Belgium by 15 September and next day attacked with the 1st Army to the southwest with the 4th Corps and the 4th and 7th Cavalry Divisions. Against the attempted French envelopment, the attack was cancelled and the corps withdrew behind the right flank of the 1st Army. The 2nd and 9th Cavalry Divisions were sent next day, but the French attack reached Carlepont and Noyon, before being contained on 18 September in the Battle of Fleury. The German armies attacked from Verdun west to Reims and the Aisne on 20 September, cut the main railway from Verdun to Paris and created the Saint-Mihiel salient. The main German effort remained on the western flank, which the French discovered by intercepting wireless messages by 28 September. The Aisne front had stabilized and the BEF began to withdraw on the night of 1/2 October, with the first troops arriving in the Abbeville area on 8-9 October. Prelude German plan of attack. After the defeat on the Marne, Moltke ordered a retirement to the Aisne by the 1st and 2nd armies on the German right wing and a withdrawal to Reims and a line eastwards past the north of Verdun. By the 3rd, 4th and 5th armies, the 6th and 7th armies were ordered to end their attacks and dig in. The withdrawal was intended to make time for the 7th army to be transferred from Alsace to the right wing near the Oise, but Franco-British attacks led to the 7th army being sent to fill the gap between the 1st and 2nd armies. Instead, Moltke was replaced by Falkenhayn on the 14th of September. By when the 1st army had reached the Aisne, with its right flank on the Oise, and the 7th army had assembled on the Aisne, between the 1st and 2nd armies further east, the 3rd, 4th and 5th armies had dug in from Prosnes to Verdun. Secure from frontal attacks, the 1st army was still vulnerable on its northern flank to attacks by French troops transferred from the south, which could be moved faster over undamaged railways than German troops using lines damaged during the Great Retreat. General Wilhelm Groener, head of the railway department of the Aisne, suggested three alternatives: a frontal attack from the new positions, a defense of the line of the Aisne while reserves were transferred to the right flank, or to continue the withdrawal and comprehensively regroup the German armies, ready to conduct an offensive on the right flank on 15 September. Falkenhayn wanted to continue the withdrawal and ordered the 1st Army to fall back and dig in from Ardems to La Fire and Nouvion et Catalan to protect the right flank from a French offensive, while the 6th Army moved from Lorraine to the western flank, ready for a general offensive to begin progressively on 18 September from the 5th Army in the east, pinning French troops down westwards, until the 6th Army enveloped the French. Beyond the right of the 1st Army, the plan was cancelled soon afterwards, when Oberst Colonel Gerhard Tappan, Aisne Operations Branch, reported from a tour of inspection at the front that the French were too exhausted to begin an offensive, that a final push would be decisive, and that more withdrawals would compromise the morale of the German troops. After the defeat on the Marne from 15-19 September, Falkenhayn ordered the 1st, 2nd, and 7th Armies, temporarily under the command command of General Karl von Bülow, to attack southwards and the 3rd, 4th and 5th armies to attack with the intention of weakening the French and preventing troops from being moved westwards. The 6th Army began to move to the western flank on 17 September, ready for a decisive battle. Schlachtentscheidung, but French attacks on 18 September, led Falkenhayn to order the 6th Army to operate defensively to secure the German flank. French plan of attack. French attempts to advance after the German retirement to the Aisne were frustrated after 14 September, when German troops were discovered to have stopped their retirement and dug in on the north bank of the Aisne. Joffre ordered attacks on the German 1st and 2nd armies, but attempts by the 5th, 9th and 6th armies to advance from 15 to 16 September had little success. The Duxieme Bureau. French military intelligence also reported German troop movements from east to west, which led Joffre to continue the transfer of French troops from the east, which had begun on 2 September with the 4th Corps and continued on 9 September with the 20th Corps, the 11th of September with the 13th Corps and the 14th Corps. On 18 September, the depletion of the French forces in the east took place just before the Battle of Fleury. A German attack on 20 September against the 3rd Army on either side of Verdun, the 5th Army north of Reims and the 6th Army along the Aisne, which ended with the creation of the Saint-Mihiel salient. Joffre maintained the French emphasis on the western flank, after receiving intercepted wireless messages, showing that the Germans were moving an army to the western flank, and continued to assemble the 2nd Army to the north of the 6th Army. On 24 September, the 2nd Army was attacked and found difficulty in holding ground. Rather than advancing round the German flank as intended, battle first phase, the 25th of September to the 4th of October, Battle of Picardy, 22-26 September. Main article, First Battle of Picardy. Initial moves, Franco-German race to the sea, 1914. The French 6th Army began to advance along the Oise, west of Compiègne on 17 September. French reconnaissance aircraft were grounded during bad weather and cavalry were exhausted, which deprived the French commanders of information as news reached Joffre that 2 German corps were moving south from Antwerp. The 6th Army was forced to end its advance and dig in around Nampsel and Roy. The 4th and 13th Corps were transferred to the 2nd Army, along with the 1st, 5th, 8th and 10th Cavalry Divisions of the Cavalry Corps General Louis Canot. The 14th and 20th Corps were withdrawn from the 1st and the original 2nd Army to assemble south of Amiens, with a screen of the 81st, 82nd, 84th and 88th Territorial Divisions, to protect French communications. The French advanced on the 22nd of September, on a line from Lassigny northwards to Roy and Scholz around the German flank, but met the German 2nd Corps, which had arrived on the night of 18-19 September, on the right flank of the 9th Reserve Corps. Despite the 4 divisions of the 2nd Cavalry Corps General Georg von der Marwitz, the Germans were pushed back to a line from Ribecourt to Lassigny and Roy, which menaced German communications through Ham and St. Quentin on 24 September. The French were attacked by the 18th Corps as it arrived from Reims, which forced back the French 4th Corps at Roy on the right flank to the north. The French reached Peronne and formed a bridgehead on the east bank of the Somme, only for the German 14th Reserve Corps to reach Bapaume to the north on 26 September. The offensive capacity of the 2nd Army was exhausted and defensive positions were occupied. While Joffre sent 4 more corps to reinforce over the next week, the northern flank of the 2nd Army moved further north, and on 29 September, a subdivision d'Armée General Louis de Maudouy was formed, to control the northern corps of the 2nd Army as they assembled near Arras. Battle of Albert, 25-29 September. Main article, Battle of Albert 1914. On 21 September, Falkenhayn decided to concentrate the 6th Army near Amiens, to attack westwards to the coast and then envelop the French northern flank south of the Somme. The offensive by the French 2nd Army forced Falkenhayn to divert the 21 and 1st Bavarian Corps as soon as they arrived, to extend the front northwards from Scholz to Peronne on 24 September and drive the French back over the Somme on 26 September. The French 2nd Army dug in on a line from Lassigny to Roy and Bray-sur-Somme. German cavalry moved north to enable the 2nd Bavarian Corps to occupy the ground north of the Somme on 27 September. The German 2nd Cavalry Corps drove back the 61st and 62nd Reserve Divisions. General Joseph Brugère, who had replaced General Albert de Maid, to clear the front for the 14th Reserve Corps and link with the right flank of the 2nd Bavarian Corps. The French subdivision d'Armée began to to assemble at Arras and Modwy found that instead of making another attempt to get round the German flank, the subdivision was menaced by a German offensive. The German 2 Bavarian and 14th Reserve Corps pushed back a French territorial division from Bapaume and advanced towards Bray-sur-Somme and Albert from 25 to 27 September. The French 21st and 10th Corps north of the Somme, with support on the right flank by the 81st, 82nd, 84th and 88th Territorial Divisions and the 1st, 3rd, 5th and 10th Cavalry Divisions of the French 2nd Cavalry Corps, defended the approaches to Albert on 28 September. The French were able to stop the German advance on a line from Maricourt to Fricourt and Thiepval. The German 2nd Cavalry Corps was stopped in the vicinity of Arras by the French cavalry on 29 September. Joffre added 10th Corps, 20 miles 32. Ruprecht intended to halt the French west of Arras and envelop them around the north side of the city on 1 October. The French attacked to the southeast, expecting only by a cavalry screen. The Germans attacked from Arras to Douai on 1 October, forestalling the French on 3 October. Ruprecht reinforced the 6th Army north of Arras and ordered the 4th Cavalry Corps from Valenciennes to Lille from 3 to 4 October. German attacks on Arras and the vicinity were costly failures on 4 October. German troops entered Lens, Suchet, Neuville-Saint-Vaast and gained a footing on the Lorette spur. German attacks were made from the north of Arras to reach the Scarpe but were eventually repulsed by 10th Corps by 4 October. German troops had also reached Givenchy and Gohel and on the right flank of the French further south. The territorial divisions were separated from 10th Corps, prompting Castelnau and Modwy to recommend a retreat. Joffre made Modwy's subdivision d'armée independent as the 10th Army and told Castelnau to keep the 2nd Army in position, because the increasing number of troops arriving further north would divert German pressure. By 6 October, the 2nd Army front from the Oise to the Somme and the 10th Army front from Thiepval to Arras and Suchet had been stabilized. A German cavalry attack to the north of the 6th Army pushed back the French territorial divisions from Lens to Lille, and on 5 October, Marwitz ordered the cavalry to advance westwards to Abbeville on the Channel coast and cut the railways leading south. At the end of 6 October, Falkenhayn terminated attempts by the 2nd Army to break through in Picardy to the north. The I and 2nd Cavalry Corps attacked between Lens and Lille and were quickly forced back behind the Lorette spur next day. The cavalry was attacked by the first troops of the French 21st Corps to arrive as they advanced eastwards from Béthune. 3rd Phase, 15 October to November. Battle of La Bassée, the 10th of October to the 2nd of November. Main article, Battle of La Bassée. La Bassée area, 1914. The German 6th Army took Lille before a British force could secure the town, and the 4th Army attacked the exposed British flank at Ypres on 9 October. The German 14th Corps arrived opposite the French, and the German 1st and 2nd Cavalry Corps tried a flanking move between La Bassée and Armentières, but the French cavalry stopped the Germans north of La Bassée Canal. The German 4th Cavalry Corps passed through Ypres on 7 October and was forced back to Bailleul by French territorial troops from 8 to 9 October. The British 2nd Corps arrived by rail at Abbeville and advanced on Béthune by the end of the 11th of October. 2nd Corps held a line from Béthune to Hinges and Chalk, with flanking units on the right, 35 miles 56. Givenchy and Pont du Hem, 6 miles 97. Messines area, 1914. The 3rd Corps reached Saint-Omer and Haysbroek from 10 to 12 October, then advanced eastwards towards Lille. The British cavalry advanced and found the Germans dug in on Mont des Cats and at Fletre on the road from Cassel to Bailleul. The 3rd Cavalry Brigade attacked Mont des Cats and occupied Mount Noir, 3 miles 48. By water meadows, the banks were cut by boggy streams and dikes, which kept the cavalry on the roads. German outposts were pushed back, but dismounted cavalry attacks could not dislodge the German defenders, and the cavalry in Wharton town were withdrawn during the night. The attack was resumed on 18 October, when the cavalry attacked from Doulimont to Tenbrilen but made no progress against a strong and well-organized German defense, ending the day opposite Doulimont in the south to the railway at Tenbrilen to the north from 9 to 18 October. The Cavalry Corps had C-175 casualties. The encounter battle ended, and subsequent operations in the Battle of Messines took place after the end of the Race to the Sea Battle of Armentières, the 13th of October to the 2nd of November. Main article, Battle of Armentières. Locations of the Allied and German armies, the 19th of October 1914. On the 11th of October, the British 3rd Corps, comprising the 4th and 6th Divisions, arrived by rail at Saint-Omer and Haysbroek and then advanced behind the left flank of 2nd Corps. Corps, towards Bailleul, and Armentières' 2nd Corps was to advance around the north of Lille, and 3rd Corps was to reach a line from Armentières to Wichate, with the Cavalry Corps Lieutenant General Edmund Allenby, 1st Viscount Allenby on the left as far as Ypres. French troops were to relieve the 2nd Corps at Béthune to move north and link with the right of 3rd Corps, but this did not occur on the northern flank of 3rd Corps. In front of the Cavalry Corps was a line of hills from Mont Des Cats to Mount Kemmel, about 400 feet 120. Day the 3rd Corps occupied Armentières on the 18th of October. The 3rd Corps was ordered to join an offensive by the BEF and the French Army, by attacking down the Lee Valley. Part of Peronchy's Ridge was captured, but much stronger German defences were encountered and the infantry were ordered to dig in on the night of 18-19 October. The 3rd Corps held a line from Ratinghem to Pont Rouge, west of Lille. The encounter battle ended and subsequent operations in the Battle of Armentières took place after the end of the race to the sea. During the First Battle of Ypres, the 19th of October to the 22nd of November. Aftermath analysis. German and Allied operations. Artois and Flanders, September to November 1914. From the 17th of September to the 17th of October, the belligerents had made unsuccessful reciprocal attempts to turn the northern flank of their opponent. A German offensive began by the 21st of October, but the 4th and 6th armies were only able to take small amounts of ground at great cost to both sides. At the Battle of the Yser, 16 to 31 October, and further south at Ypres, Falkenhayn then attempted to achieve a limited goal of capturing Ypres and Mount Kemmel. In the First Battle of Ypres, the 19th of October to the 22nd of November, by the 8th of November, Falkenhayn concluded that the attempt to advance along the coast had failed and that taking Ypres was impossible. The French and Germans had not been able to assemble forces near the northern flank fast enough to obtain a decisive advantage where the opposing forces had attempted to advance. They had quickly been stopped and forced to improvise field defenses, against which attacks were costly failures. By the end of the First Battle of Ypres, both sides were exhausted, short of ammunition, and suffering from collapses in morale and refusals of orders by some infantry units. In October 1914, French and British artillery commanders met to discuss means for supporting infantry attacks, the British practice being to keep the artillery silent until targets were identified, and the French firing a refail preliminarily. Bombardment which ceased as the infantry began the assault. A moving barrage of fire was proposed as a combination of both methods and became a standard practice later in the war as guns and ammunition were accumulated in sufficient quantity. Falkenhayn issued memoranda on 7 and 25 January 1915, defining a theory of defensive warfare to be used on the Western Front, intended to enable ground to be held with the fewest possible troops by economizing on manpower in the West. A larger number of divisions could be sent to the Eastern Front. The front line was to be fortified to enable its defense with small numbers of troops indefinitely, and captured ground were to be recovered by counter-attacks. A second trench was to be dug behind the front line, to shelter the trench garrison and to have easy access to the front line, through covered communication trenches should counter-attacks fail to recover the front trench. A rearward line was to be connected to the remaining parts of the front line, limiting the loss of ground to a bend Ausbellung in the line, rather than a breakthrough. The building of the new defences took until the autumn of 1915 and confronted Franco-British offensives with an evolving system of field fortifications, which was able to absorb the increasing power and sophistication of attempted breakthrough attacks. BEF casualties. August-December, 1914. Month losses. August 14,409, September 15,189, October 30,192, November 24,785, December 11,079. Total 95,654 during the mobile operations of 1914. Armies which operated in hostile territory were forced to rely on wireless communication to a far greater extent than anticipated, having expected to use telegraph, telephones, and dispatch riders. None of the armies had established cryptographic systems adequate to protect wireless transmissions from eavesdropping, and all of the attacking armies sent messages containing vital information in plain language from September to November. The British and French intercepted C-50 German messages, which showed the disorganization of the German command in mid-September and the gap between the 1st and 2nd armies on the eve of the Battle of the Marne. Similar plain language messages and some decodes of crudely coded German messages gave warnings to the British of the times, places, and strengths of 8 attacks by 4 German corps or more. During the race to the sea and the subsequent battles in Flanders, casualties by the end of the battles at Ypres, German army casualties in the west were 800,000 men, including 116,000 dead. The French army casualty total from October to November was 125,000 men, which, with losses of 329,000 men from August-September, gave a total of 454,000 casualties by the end of the year. In 2001, Strawn recorded 80,000 German casualties at Ypres, 89,964 British casualties since the beginning of the war, 54,105 incurred at Ypres, and that see 50% of the Belgian army had become casualties. Subsequent operations: First Battle of Flanders, Battle of the Yser, the 18th of October to the 30th of November. Main article: Battle of the Yser. Map of Yser area, 1914. During the Allied retreat from Antwerp, the British 4th Corps moved north of Ypres on the 14th of October, where 1st Corps arrived on 19 October, with cavalry covering a gap to the south of the town. The Battle of the Yser, the 18th of October to the 30th of November 1914, was fought along a 35 km 22.